Ray, what's the situation where you are out in Rye?
It's a completely different situation over here on the seacoast. The snow is continuing to fall at a heavy rate, and it's being picked up by the winds and just whipped around. Now, the winds are a little bit less than yesterday, but I tell you, if you're outside standing in it, it really doesn't feel like it. The big concern here on the seacoast is coastal flooding. As you take a look at the ocean here, waves yesterday offshore were running at about 14.4 feet. According to one report, now they're running at over 20 feet. We're still a while away, high tide at 7:50 this morning. Now here in Rye, which is where we are, police said they would be out at about 6 o'clock this morning. Yesterday, they had to repair part of the seawall along Route 1A. They're expecting similar situation today. There are a couple of good news scenarios or things working in officials' favor. One is that we're not dealing with the astronomical high tides like we're dealing with back in the blizzard. The other thing, the wind's coming out of the north, and that is tending to keep the waves, push the waves a little bit more parallel to the shore rather than just onshore. But once again, they're keeping close eye on the seas. High tide expected here in Rye at about 7:50 this morning. Reporting live, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.
All right, thanks. About an hour and a half from now, we have much more on this storm on our website, WMUR.com. You can use our interactive radar to see where the snow is falling right now and when it will end. Expected to be around lunchtime, maybe this afternoon. You can check out a complete list of closings and delays as well. We've got hundreds of them. And don't forget to share your pictures of the snow on our U Local page. We've been getting in some good ones, just like this one from Deering, showing nearly 7 inches of snow and climbing.